You're gonna wait?
No. No, they smell wonderful.
Yes. So this is, I tried something new today. This is apparently, it's called Focaccine Veneziane. It's a sweet bun.
Yeah, no kidding. It's fabulous. It's soft, buttery.
Oh, That was really good.
I was going to eat the sugar off the top.
So this was a pretty simple thing to make.
Okay.
It's essentially a modified brioche dough.
Okay, that seems simple enough.
Mm-hmm.
Stop eating, Glen.
Mm-hmm.
You can't tell them what you did if you're still eating the bun.
So I started out in a small pot with butter, honey, and milk.
Mm.
And I used some of our buckwheat honey.
Mm.
Really sort of deep and delicious flavor. And I melted that together over super low heat. You don't want to heat it. You don't want to even bring it up to body temperature. You just above room temperature a little bit so that it is melted.
Okay.
There's also 5 eggs in this.
Oh.
So I beat up the eggs a little
Whole
bit.
Eggs?
Whole eggs. Beat up the eggs a little bit. And then into a stand mixer, throw in the flour. Salt. Yeast. Sugar. Give that a bit of a mix. Put the bowl into the stand mixer. Turned it on and poured in the eggs. So I poured all the wet ingredients into the mixer. And this is a really super, super sloppy dough. Like it's...
Oh yeah?
It's, well, there's so much butter and there's so many eggs. It took quite a while for it to come together. And then I kneaded it for 8 to 10 minutes about.
Mm-hmm.
And you got a super sticky dough. So I thought I'm gonna put a little bit of flour on the bench because it'll be super sticky.
Mm-hmm.
As soon as I pulled it out of the bowl, I realized it's not gonna stick to anything. There's so much butter in this that it slid all over the place. So I formed it into a ball. Put it into a container, put a lid on it, and let it double in size, which took about 2.5 hours today because it's a little bit cooler.
Yes.
Once it had doubled in size, I put it out on the bench again, no flour this time, and broke it into 10 fairly almost kind of equal pieces. So you could break this into a dozen really small buns or 8 really big ones, whatever you want. I mean, there's no right or wrong, I don't think. Covered those and let them go for another 45 minutes or so. They rose a little bit on the baking tray, but not too much. Just before I put them in the oven, I beat up an egg and brushed that over the top of the buns. And then sprinkled on some coarse demerara sugar and put them in the oven for about 20 minutes. Pulled them out of the oven and let them cool down a little bit.
They're pretty tasty.
Mm-hmm.
I think though, I mean, they certainly don't need butter, but they do really well with some other soft fruit kind of tastes. I see you're agreeing.
I almost put raisins inside.
Really? You?
Yeah.
Raisins?
I thought raisins would go really well, but I hadn't made them before. This is the first time I'd ever made them. So I thought, okay, I'm going to make the recipe and see it. But I think raisins would go really well in here. Peel?
Like a soft apricot?
A little bit of jam or something.
Mm-hmm.
And if you're from northeastern Italy, where these apparently come from, and you don't put those sorts of things in them.
Let me know.
Why don't you put those sorts of things in them? I think it would be really great.
It could be a lot of reasons, though.
Mm-hmm.
It could be the fruit makes it too mushy. Mm-hmm. Like, I don't know. And no grandma to ask.
And it could just be tradition.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. This is really good. I'm going to get a cup of tea.
As per usual.
There's some inside.
Oh, well, in that case, I'll get the lights.